Hi everybody, welcome to the Shot Clock, and now we have it. Like it or not, there are only four teams left and they're all going to the Final Four, and so is this guy, Doug Haller, insider for all things college, and you're going to be in San Antonio. Let's go ahead and start the clock. So, it's a crazy Final Four. You got two blue bloods and you've got Michigan playing well, and then you've got the Cinderella story.
Sister Jean.
Sister Jean says she's giving up losing for Lent, so she's a little bit edgy out there too. And if you could, for us, kind of break down these four teams, you know, who's playing well, what players specifically, and then the coaching.
Here's the way I look at this, Jay. I think Villanova's the best team. I think Michigan, with what they've done, might be playing the best. Mm-hmm. Loyola, obviously, is the best story, although I don't think they're they're fluke. I mean, they've proved that they belong. And then Kansas, I think, might have the best coach with Bill Self. You know, I thought watching Sunday's game against Duke, he just carved up Mike Krzyzewski. I mean, at this point of the year, I look for a couple things in teams. One, you need playmakers. You need guys who can create their own shots, particularly at the end of the shot clock, at the end of the games. But you also need a coach who, when your team needs a basket, coming out of a timeout, who can set up your playmakers, put them in good situations. And it seemed like every time they came out of a timeout, Kansas got a great shot. You know, I saw this team in December in Lawrence against Arizona State. Like a lot of people, I didn't think they were going to win the Big 12. Obviously, they're going to the Final Four. I think it's Bill Self's best coaching season.
Yeah, it was pretty rough for the Duke fans watching Bill Self do that to them, and that hairpiece looks great. Hey, let's switch gears for a second. You've been also following ASU spring football. Herm Edwards' era has begun. Manny Wilkins appears to be the guy. What's your takeaway as far as the succession plan they might have at quarterback?
I think it's a big year for that. Obviously, Manny Wilkins going into his senior year. Here's the starting quarterback, and they have two guys behind him, Blake Barnett, the Alabama transfer, and Dylan Sterling Cole. Right now, Blake is kind of the number two guy, but I get a sense that they're really trying to give Dylan Sterling Cole as much of an opportunity to kind of take that backup spot so he can be the guy going forward.
Makes sense to me. Follow Doug in San Antonio. He's headed out, and you have a winner?
I'm going to stick with, you know what, I'm going to go with Michigan.
Okay. Don't put your money down because gambling's dangerous. For Doug, I'm Jay. Have a great day.